In COMSOL Multiphysics, the graphics window is where your geometry, mesh, and results are visualized. As such, it is useful to be aware of the many tools and options available to customize the view of your model, utilizing the graphics window toolbar buttons. In this video, we will go over how to change the view, move around your geometry within the window, hide parts of the geometry, and select geometric entities. Here we've opened up the busbar tutorial model, and the graphics window displays graphical views of the geometry, the mesh, and the results. Let's go over how to move around the geometry in the graphics window itself. To rotate the geometry, simply left-click on your mouse and drag anywhere to rotate. To move around the geometry, right-click on your mouse and again drag to move the model geometry anywhere in the window. To zoom in and out, press the scroll wheel mouse button and drag up to zoom in and down to zoom out. We can also change the view of our geometry by using the graphics window toolbar. This toolbar is dynamic and changes based on the spatial dimension of the component and the currently selected node in the model tree. Right now we have a results node selected, and as such we have the following graphics toolbar buttons. However, if we were to select the geometry node, you can see the toolbar updates. To return to the default isometric view, we can use the go to default view button. And besides using your mouse scroll wheel to zoom in and out, we can use the zoom in and zoom out buttons to do the same, as well as use the zoom box to zoom in on a particular area of the model geometry. You can also use the zoom extents button to zoom out to the extent that the geometry completely fills the graphics window. We also have several plane view buttons, so you can view the geometry from the direction of the plane you would like. We can view the geometry on the XY plane and click that button again to view the geometry on the opposite end, and do the same with the YZ plane and ZX plane. We can also change the graphics rendering to help with the visualization of the geometry, and this is helpful especially when selecting geometry. We can toggle on or off scene lighting, use transparency, or we can also use a wireframe rendering of the model. Let's leave the transparency on, so it makes it easier when we are selecting geometric entities. I will demonstrate how to select a geometric entity in the graphics window by using one of our materials nodes. So I'll clear the selection. And in order to select a geometric entity in the graphics window, we just hover with the mouse over the part that we want to include in our selection, and you'll see the geometry is highlighted in red. So we can go ahead and click. And you can see now we've applied the material copper to the busbar domain. To choose between overlapping geometric entities, we can utilize the mouse scroll wheel button to select geometry. This is helpful when you're trying to select any hard-to-reach geometric entities or internal boundaries. I will demonstrate how to select a geometric entity in the graphics window by using one of our materials nodes. So I'll clear the selection, turn off the active switch so I can scroll through those domains to show. And let's say we wanted to apply this material copper to the boundary between these two bolts. Well, we can zoom in a little further and hold the mouse over the boundary that we want, and then use the mouse scroll wheel to eventually select that part. In this way, we can choose parts of the geometry. For example, a material or boundary condition is applied. To hide or show geometric entities in your model, first you would need to select the level of geometry that you want to choose from. So here we've selected domain, and then we select the click and hide button. Let's say we wanted to hide one of the bolts in the bus bar. We hover over the part of the geometry we want to hide, click to hide it, and then continue for any other entities that we want to hide. Let's say we also want to hide a boundary. We can do that as well. We'll click and hide a few of those, and then when you are finished selecting the geometry that you want to hide, be sure to deselect the click and hide button. So now you can view the inside of your geometry and other parts that are maybe harder to see without actually changing or affecting any of your geometry. We can view all of the unhidden entities by using the view unhidden button. We can view the hidden entities only by using the view hidden only button. And we can use the view all button to display all hidden and unhidden geometry. Also, when you hide parts of the geometry, COMSOL Multiphysics automatically creates an explicit selection list of these entities. You can find this by going under the Definitions node and under the View node. You can then rename the explicit selection and modify the list of entities that are hidden. If you ever want to start over, you can always use the Reset Hiding button to reset all hidden entities. By utilizing the Graphics Window and Toolbar buttons, you can completely customize your view of the model to obtain different perspectives of your analysis as needed.